Organic chemistry is all about the chemistry of carbon. Carbon is a small molecule. Carbon has four electron clouds. The electron clouds are the same, and they point out in all directions equally. They repel each other, and the result of this is that the four clouds stick out equally in all directions. If the four clouds each have a hydrogen atom, then it makes a molecule called methane. Methane has to be the simplest organic compound. The structure it makes is called a tetrahedron. A tetrahedron is like a triangle sort of thing. Sometimes you see them, sometimes you see a dice that's a four-sided dice instead of a six-sided dice. So methane is the simplest organic compound. And as a student, you might say, well, methane, what's the big deal? Methane may well be the most important compound in our industrial world. Methane is natural gas. So carbon likes to form four equal bonds, and it'll form them with hydrogen. But very importantly, carbon will form bonds with itself. And so if there's two of them, this is kind of like two methanes stuck together. You have a methane, but one of the hydrogens has another carbon on it, so it makes ethane. Methane and ethane are both gases. And then if you put a third one on, you get propane. Notice how there's three of them? And so methane and ethane and propane are both gases. They all burn. And there's complications, but I don't think they're very important, and I think we ought to just move forward. If there's four in a row, then you get butane. And butane, it's really not, it's not terribly different. There's four atoms of carbon, and that's about all there is to it. There's four of them. Okay, let's take a look at methane again. We have methane, ethane, propane, and butane. Let's take a quick look at methane. We see that there's four of them, and I think it's rather obvious that the four hydrogens are the same, or the four locations are the same. Let's ask the same question about ethane, only let's kind of add a little bit. Let's make one of them different. Okay, if one of them is different, you could say, well, does it matter which one it is? So one of them is different, but does it matter which one it is? One of the tricks to this is that this bond rotates. So the bond rotates, and wherever you put it, it could be put in the other position. So that for ethane, there are six locations, and all of them are the same. Okay, let's do the same question for propane. And that is, we take the propane. Notice again that the bonds rotate. Okay, there's the bonds between the carbons rotate. So let's put something different. Let's don't worry too much about what it is. Let's put something different on here. And we can see that, okay, this is quite a bit more complicated, but if you look at the one that's different, so it's the same on here. But if you turn it around this way, it's the same over here. So that these three and these three are exactly the same. Let's put the green guy, let's put him in the middle. And if he's in the middle, you can see that in the middle is not the same as on the ends. So the bonds rotate. These guys rotate, but this one is different. But if you look at this one, it's different. But this one is the same as this one. So this one is the same as this one. These two are the same. So this one's the same as this one. So for propane, there's two possibilities. Okay, let's do the same thing with butane. Okay, butane, again, the bonds rotate. Okay, the bonds rotate. And it's a little bit different on this one because this middle bond rotates and it'll form a compound that looks like this, as well as a compound that looks like this. And this compound is a little bit different. It's not terribly different, but it's a little bit different. And then, of course, these guys rotate too. Okay, well, let's put a different one on. We take an end one and put it on. And I think we can pretty easily see that, okay, these ones are all the same. But if the green one was on the other end over here, so if this one was here, it would be the same thing. So there's six locations on the ends, and they're all the same. And then let's look at the ones in the middle. Okay, let's say we put it in the middle. Well, if it's in the middle, it's clearly not the same thing. It's clearly not the same thing. But if you look carefully, you can see that, okay, we have the green one here, but if it was here, it would be the same thing. But if the green one was here, it would be the same thing. So the four in the middle are also the same. So the six on the outside are the same. The four in the middle are the same. So that for butane, there's two possibilities. It can either be on the outside or it can be on the inside. Okay, so we have methane, ethane, which has two. This guy's missing a ball. Go ahead and put him on here. Ethane, propane, which has three. Ethane, which has four. Well, it might be easy to guess that if we put five on, we can put five on, and the name will be pentane, which is Roman or Latin or something for five. But there's five, one, two, three, four, five. The bonds rotate. Again, all of these bonds rotate. So this is kind of a big floppy thing now. You know, it can flop around and stuff like that. But let's, the carbons form strong bonds with themselves, but they can form bonds with more than one. So here, let's go straight to ordinary butane. So this has four, right? But if this one is here, so what's this guy? Well, if you notice, it has four. One, two, three, four. I mean, this is really also a butane. It has four carbon, so it's a butane, but it's not exactly the same. And I don't think that the details are terribly important to us here, but I think you should be aware that the structures can get real complicated. So let's look at pentane in the same level. Let's say that we take this guy. Oh, and again, looking at butane, there's only one way it can form. Like, this guy's on the end, or it's not on the end. So there's only two possibilities for butane. There's only two ways it can go: this way, and then with them all in a row. Let's look at pentane on the same level. Let's take this guy off of here, and let's put him here. Okay, I would call this a pentane also. It has five carbons. One, two, three, four, five. So is there another way to do it? Kind of, students, ask yourself this. Is there another way to do that? Well, if we take the carbon and put it on this one, we're going to get the same thing. So I say this is the only possibility. I can't think of another one. It's either on the end or it's not. So it's a little bit like the butane, in that there's only two possibilities. Let's look at yet one more possibility. Would be that this guy goes on here. Ah, that's right. This guy goes on here, and then this guy goes on here, and now we've got four. So we've got the one in the middle, and then we've got four all the way rotating around it. So this would also be a pentane. And that's it. These guys all burn. There are complications, but I don't think they're very important. I think the idea at this point is to just get an idea that the molecules can get real complicated really quickly. I don't think we need to look any further at it than that. But this guy, I think he's kind of cool. So this actually is a tetrahedron inside of a tetrahedron. So this whole structure is a tetrahedron, actually. If you take, I have a glass of water here. If you take this water and put it in a pan and put it on a stove and put the heat on under it, the pan will warm up, and the water will warm up, and the water will get warmer and warmer and warmer. At some point, it'll kind of start to bubble a little bit, and then it'll start to bubble. The temperature at which it actually starts boiling is very precise. It's like there's a cutoff where the water is boiling or it's not boiling. And at sea level, it's 100 degrees centigrade and 212 degrees Fahrenheit, as we know. The same rule applies to any pure compound. The world of pure compounds, water is really the only good example we have in our everyday life. But it applies to methane. Methane, the same rule applies to methane. You can find liquid methane, but you have to go to Jupiter. Mars is too warm for liquid methane. You have to go all the way to Jupiter. And you can find liquid ethane, but you have to go to Mars. So on Mars, you can have liquid ethane, but you can't have liquid methane. And then propane, you almost can. Propane, it's got to be really, really, really cold to get liquid propane. If you want to put a flammable gas in a bottle, you could put methane in a bottle, but it would have to be a really strong bottle, or it would have to be really cold. And you can put ethane similarly in a bottle, but not really. If you want to put a flammable gas in a bottle, like for barbecues, you use propane. Because the boiling point, I don't know, but you don't have to pressurize it all that much. And it doesn't need a big, strong container. It needs to be contained. And then if you want to put a flammable gas in a little plastic lighter, you got to use butane. Because butane is almost a liquid at room temperature. Butane is kind of like a wannabe liquid. And then pentane is a liquid at room temperature. I mean, an image would be if you took a jar, a container of pentane, and went outside and poured it on the ground, the pentane would almost not reach the ground. It's so volatile. It explodes into vapor. Explodes, not probably the right word, but it springs from the liquid phase to the vapor phase so quickly that it's almost like it won't even reach the ground. If you poured it on the ground and then got down on your hands and knees, you wouldn't be able to find any pentane down there. It would be gone. Pentane is, of course, flammable, and if you poured it on the ground and lit a match, that would be a really bad idea. So we have methane. Methane is the simplest organic compound. Methane, carbon, with four hydrogens. What happens if we swap out one of the carbons for something else? And the example I want to use is the OH group. The OH group is, you can think of it as part of water. Water is H2O, which is HOH. If you take one of the hydrogens off, you end up with an OH group, and I just want to let it go at that. If you take the methane and put an OH group on it, the OH group makes it into a compound that's surprisingly different for only having one atom different. The oxygen is actually bigger than the carbon. So you have a carbon and an oxygen, but the oxygen is bigger, and the oxygen dominates the behavior of the compound now. So it's no longer a carbon thing, it's more like an oxygen thing. And the result of it is that the methane turns into methyl alcohol. It turns into an alcohol. I think the trivial word for it is wood alcohol. Wood alcohol is used as a solvent sometimes, it's used as a fuel sometimes. It's been around since the very, very earliest times. Microorganisms will produce methanol sometimes. It's used in lamps. Used to be used in lamps. It's a pretty common industrial compound, methanol. So from methane, we go to methanol. And from ethane, we go to ethanol. And ethanol it's a very big, important compound in our world, partly because it's a naturally occurring compound in our society. And this goes back since the dawn of time. Yeast ferment sugar and they produce ethyl alcohol. So ethanol is the alcohol that is found in fermented beverages like beer and wine and whiskey. And it can be metabolized by human beings. And in addition to that, ethanol is a fuel. And they add it to gasoline. Oxygenated fuel refers, it could be a lot of different things, but it probably refers to ethanol. It's an oxygenated fuel, but ethanol can be used as a fuel. And then propanol, if you take propane and put the same OH group on it, it turns into propanol. Propanol is also a fuel. It's also flammable. Propanol is a little bit different because there's two ways the oxygen can go on. The oxygen can go on the end, but it also can go on in the middle. And if it's in the middle or if it's on the end, it's not the same thing. Exactly. It's pretty close to the same thing. And it has a different name. So if the oxygen is in the middle, it's called isopropanol. And if it's on the end, it's called propanol or N-propanol. And notice how if it's on the end, it doesn't matter which end it's on, because both ends are the same. This end is the same as this end. And if it's in the middle, it doesn't matter which of the two it's on, because they're both the same. And the small alcohols like propanol, methanol, and even butanol they're liquids. Their boiling point goes up as the molecule gets bigger, similar to the gases. They could be used as fuels. It would be possible to take an automobile and, with minor modifications, run it on methanol or ethanol. And of course, ethanol is added to gasoline. Oxygenated fuel has ethanol added to it. And one of the things that's happened in our society is that they take corn, ferment it into ethyl alcohol, and add that to gasoline. So oxygenated fuel has ethanol in it, and the ethanol is oxygenated fuel because it has an oxygen on it.